We're also moving drilling equipment out of the storm's projected paths. However, experts say the disruptions are likely to lead to a big spike in fuel prices. That's largely because most gasoline producers have a large inventory on hand. On top of that, demand has been low since the start of the pandemic. Devastating images from where Marco and Laura have been or are headed. Let's check in now with Storm Center 7 meteorologist Jesse Mag.
Yeah, right now both of those are just tropical storms, but one of those soon enough will begin strengthening very rapidly. It's not Marco that's soon actually already impacting parts of the Florida Panhandle as well as parts of Mississippi and Georgia there. So this one is not going to carry a whole lot of strength. It's Laura that's down towards Cuba right now. Once that gets into open water in the Gulf of Mexico, it's really going to take off. Marco, on the other hand, is dealing with some strong upper-level winds, and you kind of see that white scatter off towards the north. That's the winds almost ripping apart the storm. So this will likely not strengthen from this point on. In fact, weaken as it moves throughout Louisiana, bringing a lot of rain for the south right now. So that one's going to bring a lot of rain, and it's not good because there's one shortly thereafter. Laura is going to become a hurricane, strengthening very quickly with possibly Category 2 strength winds. So this one's definitely one to pay attention to as it strengthens in the Gulf of Mexico. Soon after that, it will swing up, jump on the jet stream, and actually curve its way back towards the Ohio Valley. So this could have an impact on us back home. Once it makes landfall, again, it jumps on the jet stream, it combines with another low pressure system, and then that is going to transfer all that moisture from the Gulf of Mexico to us. And I think it's going to be a very rainy day, at least for the second half of the day there on Friday. So something to pay attention to as we head into the weekend. Here right now, we're looking at a few thunderstorms that are slowly creeping their way into the region right now in the northwestern Miami Valley. Nothing too impressive with this. You see a couple lightning strikes there in the Muncie, Indiana area. This rain is going to move its way towards places like Greenville and Salina throughout the next couple of hours, but I anticipate it to weaken as the morning goes on. We do have some patches of fog that have developed out there. Springfield and Urbana down kind of the lowest in the Miami Valley. We also have Eaton right now that's recording at the sensor, a half mile visibility. I think that might be a little bit lower than what it actually is, but perhaps some dense fog there in Eaton and especially down towards the Ohio River Valley. That's where we're seeing some of that fog really become quite dense down towards the south. So maybe add a couple minutes if you're within those areas. A future cast right now throughout the day is going to pick up those showers and storms I showed you, kind of weakening as they move towards us throughout the morning hours. Then into the afternoon, the heat of the day will bubble up some scattered showers and storms, not necessarily widespread by any means, kind of like yesterday where we just had a few pop-up downpours that developed throughout the heat of the day there. So that will likely quiet down as we head into the evening once the sun sets. And overnight tonight actually looks very quiet. 70 degrees, humid, with mostly clear skies out there. Now tomorrow, we have a boundary that's going to drift from north to south, and that could spark up a few showers and thunderstorms, possibly becoming severe, especially as you head off towards the northeastern Miami Valley. So good chances for rain throughout the work week, starting off kind of low there for the first 3 days, scattered or isolated. But things become really wet as we head into Thursday and Friday. And remember, that tropical storm is likely the result of that rain there on Friday. Hot and humid for the next 5 days. So make sure you dress light throughout the work week here. But some cool air looks to move back in for the weekend. We're bringing you weather and traffic every 10 minutes. Let's head back over to Sergeant Mark. Check on the roads. Good morning, Sarge.
Jesse, good morning to you. Monday morning drive has been pretty uneventful so far. We've been in touch with several of our area police departments, our dispatch centers. Everyone's reporting a quiet drive, everyone that we've talked to so far. Here's Interstate 70. This is the camera by Airport Access Road. Light volume here. If you do have to head out to the airport, certainly you can take the freeway and get there without a problem. I'm Sergeant Mark Bowery, WHIO Team Traffic.
It is 521, 70 degrees. Peaches are being pulled from the shelves because they could make you sick. The bacteria lurking inside, and how to know if your peaches are bad.